A former Christchurch creche supervisor swept up in the Peter Ellis saga is calling for accountability after the case was declared a miscarriage of justice. Gaye Davidson was one of four female workers accused of child sex abuse alongside the late Mr. Ellis. Their charges were dropped while Mr. Ellis was convicted and spent 7 years in jail. Kushla Norman reports.
It's the headline Gaye Davidson always hoped for. Her former co-worker, Peter Ellis, exonerated of child sex abuse convictions 3 years after his death.
He was strong in his beliefs that the children had to know, and he would keep fighting until they did. And I'm just so sorry he's not here today to see this has come so far.
The controversy ensnared Gaye.
You know what you're charged with?
And three other women who worked at the creche. Their homes were raided, looking for evidence of bizarre acts of abuse the police could never prove.
We were supposed to put children in microwaves and have people coming through concrete ceilings and taking them to the QE2 and throwing them in the pool.
On Friday, the Supreme Court found Peter Ellis suffered a miscarriage of justice. The memories of the children had become contaminated through questions from parents, and the psychiatrist Karen Zellis's evidence departed from appropriate standards.
There's quite a few people that should be held responsible for the miscarriage that's happened. Of course, Karen Zellis, with her, overzealous approach to try and prove something.
But the parents of the child complainants disagree with the decision. In a statement on Friday, they said that the trauma of not being believed over the years takes its toll, and the court of public opinion is often ill-informed.
But the ordeal also took its toll on Gaye.
There was no way I would ever be employed in childcare again, but more importantly, there's no way I wanted to be employed in childcare because it frightened me. I was scared.
A painful chapter over, but questions remain over who was responsible. Kushla Norman, One News.